We take our back-end video processing pipelines, connect them to public video feeds, and then essentially detect activity in the video feeds. And we take those measures in aggregate and convert them into what we call the physical distancing index.
I can decide a stay-at-home order.
Today I'm issuing a stay-home, stay-safe executive order for all Michiganders.
You must stay at home.
This is certainly an unprecedented impact to our daily lives. And what we're trying to do is really create a tool that can be used to increase public awareness.
University of Michigan professor Jason Corso is the CEO at Voxel 51, a company that uses computer vision to create insights from video. In response to COVID-19, the team has paused their core work to focus on the public distancing index tool to inform people on how social distancing measures are being followed in real time.
It takes a time-based window over a number of hours and shows the peak amount of activity over that time-based window. But we do plot vertical gray lines along the graphs as well. Those vertical gray lines are news instances that have occurred. Some of them are global, like St. Paddy's Day, but some of them are very local, like in New York City. I think the parks were closed
beginning yesterday.
We are beginning the conversations with a number of municipalities about how to use this type of tool, both from a governing point of view, and just are our statutes being observed? Do we need to put different types of measures in place? As well as from a taxpayer or a citizen point of view, if I need to walk my dog, I want to know where in what region of the city could I go in that has the least amount of foot traffic typically so I can be safest and keep my physical distance. The virus is spreading, but the public response to the mandates has been rather dramatic and impressive. So we should all be proud or happy about what we're doing for that.